second chapter, respiration. In the chapter, in previous class, I already explained about anaerobic respiration, that is cellular respiration. In that cellular respiration, we already learned about the aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. In this process, when the glucose can oxidize, it produces two molecules of three carbon compound product. That name is pyruvate. Understood, children? When this pyruvate can oxidized, here two conditions are going on there. What are those? One is in the presence of oxygen, and the second one is in the absence of oxygen. So, presence of oxygen we call as aerobic respiration, and the absence of oxygen we call as anaerobic respiration. I already explained in anaerobic respiration takes place in bacteria and yeast cells. What are the end products we can observe after the completion of aerobic respiration? That is, lactic acid and energy can be released in bacteria, and ethanol, carbon dioxide and large amount of energy can be released during the process of aerobic respiration in yeast, that is the fungal species. But in case of eukaryotic cells, what are those? Plants and animals. Aerobic respiration will take place. So when the pyruvate is oxidized, what happened? What are the products you are going to see here? That is water, carbon dioxide, and a large amount of energy can be released. Understood, children? Now let's go and see. If we work muscular work, that is mostly pedaling cycles or jogging, running, climbing stairs. All these are the muscular works only, na? Understood, children? And then others. These others have to participate in running race, 100 meters running race like that, na? So they want to run very fast to reach their destiny. So during the reaching of their destiny, they can use their muscular energy. They need more energy to reach their destiny. So during the process, they cannot respire. Aerobic respiration will not take place during jogging, running or pedaling cycles. Fast if you pedaling cycle, what happened? We can concentrate to reach the destiny. So at that time, anaerobic respiration will take place even in case of human beings also. So what is the end product we are going to see here? That is the production of lactic acid. What is that? Lactic acid. So after completion of pedaling cycle or running race, then what did you feel? You can feel pain, cramps, muscle cramps. So what is the reason for that? That is due to the accumulation of lactic acid in muscles. We already know that now. In case of bacteria, during anaerobic conditions, lactic acid is produced now. Even in humans also, if there is no anaerobic respiration, aerobic respiration, while jogging or pedaling cycle, while doing any muscular activities, you cannot participate in aerobic condition. What is the process that takes place there? While doing muscular works, anaerobic respiration will take place. So here we can see the production of lactic acid. So when the lactic acid can accumulate in the blood, so where it can produce? It can carry by this blood vena, who can transport the substances to entire body. That is, blood only can transport. Through blood, this lactic acid can accumulate the entire body. So we are feeling pain. After completion of your muscular work, then you can get relaxed. At that time, again, aerobic respiration will take place. Then the lactic acid can disappear. It can be converted into energy. It can again convert into glucose. Understood, children? When did you get energy? Glucose only will provide energy to our body. Understood, children? So, during aerobic conditions, we can breathe air. From that air, 21% of oxygen is present in the atmosphere now. 5% of oxygen can remains in the alveoli, that is in the lungs, that can be circulated or transported by blood. Then what happened here? The production of glucose can take place. Then we are getting energy. Then we can relief from this muscle or pain. Understood, children? So that process we call as oxygen bank. Understood, children? Now I'll explain about, I already said about the yeast cells. When the anaerobic respiration will take place in yeast cells, energy can release, ethanol can release, and there is a release of heat. Temperature can release. I'll explain by conducting an activity. Understood, children? What is that activity? During anaerobic conditions, the yeast cells can produce ethanol and then carbon dioxide, and the temperature can release, heat can release. Now I'll explain the activity. So before starting that activity, what we want to follow, we have to follow some rules. What is the first one? That is aim. What is the aim? What we want to prove, that is the aim. So what we want to prove by doing this activity? To prove that release of carbon dioxide and heat during anaerobic respiration with yeast cells. That is the aim. And then the next step is apparatus. Apparatus in the sense, what are the materials want to need to conduct this experiment? So simply what we call them apparatus. Materials required are apparatus. So for this experiment, what are the apparatus? Thermos flask, then wash bottle, and then thermometer, delivery tubes, then splitting cork to hold rubber cork. Understood, children? Here one, and here one more cork we already used. And then what are the substances we are going to use here? That is glucose solution with yeast cells. That is also the glucose already boiled, and then cold glucose solution we have to use in this experiment. And then paraffin liquid. Paraffin liquid in the sense wax. Wax. Okay. And the next one is bicarbonate solution, that is called lime water. These are the materials required to conduct an activity. Understood, children? Now let's go and explain the procedure. What is the procedure? What is the process is going on there during anaerobic respiration? So before starting this experiment, now you have to take the glucose solution, then boil the glucose solution. But you can just boil it, but don't steam the glucose solution. If continuously you can steam the glucose solution, what happens? The glucose can break down. So don't steam the glucose solution, just you have to boil. Why we are going to boil process? To remove the oxygen from the glucose. Why we are removing oxygen from the glucose? Do you know what is the reason for that? We are conducting anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic in the sense absence of oxygen. So we must remove oxygen from the glucose solution and then cool it. Understood, children? After boiling the glucose solution, let it be cool. After that, pour into this thermos flask. Understood? And the next, for confirmation, if the glucose is present in oxygen is present in the glucose solution or not, you have to conduct a confirmation test, a simple test. That is, add a few drops of dicing green. What is the name? better to take crushed black grapes or peel of apple. The skin of these two fruits you have to collect and then add into this glucose solution. So these are the rich of yeast. So that only we are selecting black grape skin or apple peel. Anyone you have to select. Otherwise, better to bring dry yeast in the market. Understood, children? Then pour paraffin liquid at least 1 inch thickness. Understood, children? By to remove the, it can prevent the flow of air into the bottle and outside the bottle. Understood? And then insert the thermometer to measure the temperature and arrange the delivery tubes into both thermos flask and then in wash bottle. Understood, children? And we are already using lime water bicarbonate solution. So previously I already said that when the lime water will turn into milky white precipitate, what it indicates? That is due to the action of carbon dioxide. The lime water can turn into milky white precipitate. Okay, children. So here you have to conduct an arrangement like that and just leave it at least 2 or 3 days. Or within 1 day also you can observe it. But the lime water is in liquid form. But if you go into 2 days, then what happened? The complete lime water can evaporate and it produces just like a precipitate form. Okay, so here the whole process will take place here like that. And every 2 hours you can note down the reading of the thermometer. So what did you observe? The temperature then gradually increased every 2 hours. So what did you understand? The yeast cells can participate in anaerobic respiration during that process. Energy can be released in the form of heat that can be measured by using thermometer. Understood, children? Clear or not? And then after 2 days, what happened? Anaerobic respiration will take place. Already we added yeast cells. Then when you have to smell this glucose solution, what did you observe? The glucose solution is turned just like an alcohol in nature. Ethanol smell will get from this glucose solution. That is the action of yeast during anaerobic respiration. These yeast cells can produce ethanol. And we already know that temperature can increase. And then here the lime water can turn into milky white precipitate. That is due to the release of carbon dioxide from these yeast cells. Understood, children? Clear or not? Here we can observe the glucose solution become turned into ethanol or alcoholic smell. When we have to smell this glucose solution, we can feel ethanol and alcoholic smell. And then the lime water can turn into milky white precipitate. That is due to the release of CO2. Understood? And when we have to observe the thermometer, the reading of the thermometer can gradually increase. So temperature can increase and then lime water can turn into milky white precipitate and the glucose solution we are getting a smell, that is ethanol smell. So here this is ethanol and then temperature, heat can release and then CO2 can release. So during anaerobic respiration with yeast cells, we can conclude that the production of ethanol and then a release of carbon dioxide during anaerobic respiration and the temperature also can released, that is heat can release in the form of energy. This is called anaerobic respiration.